Better look better, better. Nigga, I gotta be safe.
Let's get some sports talk.
Tied at half, just 7 points in the second half. Yeah. What were the key adjustments you guys made?
Just went back to playing some zone. We went back to some blitz and put more pressure on the quarterback. Our guys made some plays when they needed to.
When we talked to you yesterday, you thought it would take 40 points or more to win. You score 42. Yeah. How would you describe what's so effective about this offense right now?
You know, efficiency, great quarterback, great skill guys. Offensive line did a tremendous job of protecting today. Joe did a tremendous job of scrambling when he had pressure. And give credit to Steve Ensminger, Joe Brady, the offensive staff. They had a tremendous game plan.
Finally, Ed, you talk so often about what this place means to this state. What does a night like this mean for this program?
Well, I guarantee you, this is winning edge tonight was our home field. And I can't thank our crowd so much. We came to the Tiger Walk. There must have been 30,000 people there at the end when they all get the gator chomp, man. I was fired up.
Go celebrate with Kelly and everybody else. Congratulations, Ed.
Go Tigers.
Let's go to Maria with Joe Burrow.
All right, thanks, Tom. Your coach was just talking about Tiger Walk and there being 30,000 people out there. You just welcomed in a team for a night game for the first time as a ranked opponent. What was it like playing in this game and being able to assert yourself?
In this atmosphere, second.
He don't get talked about as much he should because he got LSU back, being a top-ranked team this year. And I feel like they should talk about him more because he got NFL potential and he a good chance to be a good player in the NFL. He don't get talked about as much as he should, how he got LSU on a winning streak and got them to 6-0. And they having a good year with him at quarterback. And he's showing his draft stock is going to be higher. It should be, because the way he got LSU back on the map, how they used to be. But he don't get as talk as much like Tua, Herbert from Oregon. He don't get mentioned as much like them or Justin Fields. He don't get mentioned as a lot. He's underrated as a QB in college. And he should be getting talked about just like them because he having a good season so far this year. And he's helping LSU fight for a playoff spot coming up because how he playing. Yeah, he got to get past Alabama. If they stay undefeated, that's who's going to be in the SEC title game. But he don't get mentioned as much. That's why I feel like he's going to ease his way on into the NFL and somebody going to pick him up. He's going to be a top pick because what he doing this season. Like, you got LSU back as a ranked team because they have been above average for a little few years. Now he got them at the top and he don't get mentioned as much as everybody else.
Not in the country. And, you know, we played a great team. We came out on top. I mean, that was such a great game. I'm kind of speechless right now.
You guys were down going into halftime, but came out and scored 21 unanswered points. What changed for you on the offense?
We knew the defense was going to get stops. We knew on offense we were just going to have to keep doing what we were doing. We felt like they couldn't stop us all night. We kind of just killed ourselves on some drives, but our defense really stepped up in the second half.
293 yards, 3 touchdowns. How is this offense continuing to label itself as explosive every single night?
I think you're seeing it on the field. I think, you know, we have a lot of room to improve still, but tonight was a great stepping stone for us.
All right, thanks for your time, Jeff.
Thank you.
And Burrow's on pace to break the LSU single season yardage passing record. 80% completion on the field after a 21 for 24 night to night. 3 more touchdown passes and so calm and such command out there.
I think command is the word of the year for what he's doing in this new offense. And you can tell the comfort level. This guy prepares like an NFL quarterback. Here's the RPO game. It's a big part of this offense. He start to get down, you want to help in the run, he's going to throw the football behind you. Has such a good feel for when the defense tries to sneak up and blitz the safeties. And let's give a lot of credit to these receivers. They made so many plays. Here's a little rough route late that eventually was the game winner. Able to sneak Jamar Chase on a rough route. Look at the accuracy downfield. Makes it easy for the wide receivers to make plays. And Chase and Jefferson both, tremendous night. And like I said, really the beneficiaries of this new offense.
Different looking passing game. There was only the one real big deep shot to Chase and the touchdown that you just saw. There are a lot of very efficient, effective stuff underneath. Balanced with the running game, though. They only ran 48 plays, 24 runs, 24 passes, but a lot more productive on the ground than we've seen from them.
But I think that shows you the versatility. If you think as you're scouting LSU and you look at Auburn down the road and you look at Alabama, you think, well, they're going to match up against Burrow and those receivers. Well, tonight with Edwards-Helaire, you see the balance Chris just talked about with the numbers, but he was getting room to run. And people now are starting to get so worried in their scouting report about what are we going to do about Burrow and all these crossing routes. It's opening up the offensive line and the running game. I think they're going to become more and more balanced. Almost a pick-your-poison type of approach from Burrow in command, Joe Brady, Steve Insminger calling the shots from up top, and the way they're executing right now, as good as any offense in the country.
Long way to go, but I'll put you on the spot. Is this team built to get through Mississippi State, Auburn, and then the trip at Alabama coming up later
on? I think
on?
They are because of the offense. This is a different LSU team. It's no longer about defense and just being smart and efficient on offense. They're attacking. And, you know, Tua, you want to peek down the road at Tua and Joe Burrow. To me, there are a lot of quarterbacks out there. They talk about this being the year of the quarterbacks. To me right now, there are two guys that are executing in the passing game at a very different level than everybody else. And it's Tua, who's running Sark's system from the NFL, the Falcons last year, and what we're seeing tonight from Joe Burrow and really all year with Joe Brady bringing that system over from the New Orleans Saints.
And those are the two.
And look what he's doing in that system. He has someone that fed his skills. And that's why he's succeeding. Like, when you got someone that could know how to plug you in and something that fits you, you will be successful. And that's what it is. And that system, he fit it. Now, he go to Alabama and beats Alabama. He should be talked about after that. If he go toe-to-toe with Tua and pulled it off, he should be mentioned for a top pick in this draft if he goes. Because the season he having, he should be talked about more, but he's underrated, and that's why he's doing all this. He know anybody talking about him as much as they should. You might hear them when you turn on the Sports Center, but they don't really talk about it like they should be. How he got LSU going. When the defense ain't playing well, he's right there to back them up and keep them in the games and pull off wins. And if he go out of Alabama, go toe-to-toe and beat them, he should be talked about. Because Tua is a top pick at the quarterback position, and he should be mentioned if he pulls that off.
Remaining unbeaten teams in the SEC with Georgia and now Florida falling, LSU and Alabama, and those two quarterbacks you mentioned on a collision course in Tuscaloosa. But that's down the road. Tonight, a satisfying W with the Bayou Bengals by 14 over the Florida Gators.
What's up? Thank you so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. Don't forget to download the ESPN app, and if you want